Hello everyone. How are you doing? Today channel, Dance Sreyoun is going to present you 40 basic English phrases you'll use over and over. Here are the 40 basic English phrases. 1. Hi, I am, name. And you? Here's an informal greeting you can use when you meet new friends. If the person does not tell you their name, you can say your name first. Then ask, and you? Or in what is your name? For example, hi, I am Rebecca. And you? Too. Nice to meet you. After you learn each other's names, it is polite to say this phrase. For example, A, hi, Rebecca, I am Chad. B, nice to meet you, Chad. Nice to meet you, too. 3. Where are you from? Ask this question to find out which country someone is from. You answer this question with I am from, group of underscores. Can you answer this question in English? Say both the question and answer aloud right now. 4 times, remember? For example, nice to meet you, Sergio. So, where are you from? B, I am from Spain. 4. What do you do? Most adults ask each other this question when they meet. It means what do you do for a living? What is your job? I think this question is boring, so I ask other questions. But many people will probably ask you this, so it is important to know what it means. For example, A. What do you do, Kathleen? B. I work at the university as a financial specialist. 5. What do you like to do in your free time? Instead of asking for someone's job title, I prefer to ask what they enjoy doing. The responses, answers, are usually much more interesting. For example, so, Kathleen, what do you like to do in your free time? B, I love to read and to garden. I picked 2 buckets of tomatoes last week. 6. What is your phone number? If you want to keep in contact with someone you just met, ask this question to find out their phone number. You can replace phone number with email address if you want to know their email address. For example, you might also hear people use the more casual, can I get your phone number? It would be great to meet up again sometime. What is your phone number? 7. Do you have Facebook? Many people keep in touch, contact, through Facebook. Use this question to find out if someone has a Facebook account. You might also ask, are you on Facebook? For example, let's keep in touch. Do you have Facebook? 8. Thanks so much. This is a simple sentence you can use to thank someone. To add detail, say, thanks so much plus for plus, noun, slash, in verb. For example, thanks so much for the birthday money. Thanks so much for driving me home. 9. I really appreciate. You can also use this phrase to thank someone. For example, you might say, I really appreciate your help. Or you can combine number 1 and number 2, thanks so much for cooking dinner. I really appreciate it. Thanks so much. I really appreciate your cooking dinner. 10. Excuse me. When you need to get through but there's someone blocking your way, say excuse me. You can also say this phrase to politely get someone's attention. For example, excuse me, sir, you dropped your wallet. Excuse me, do you know what time it is? 11. I am sorry. Use this phrase to apologize, whether for something big or small. Use 4 to give more detail. For example, I am sorry for being so late. I am sorry for the mess. I was not expecting anyone today. You can use really to show you are very sorry for something. I am really sorry I did not invite you to the party. In fact, I am sorry has many different uses in English and they are not always that obvious. Because of this, using native content when learning English expressions is very important to ensure you are learning them properly. 12. What do you think? When you want to hear someone's opinion on a topic, use this question. For example, I am not sure if we should paint the room yellow or blue. What do you think?
13.
How does that sound? If you suggest an idea or plan, use this phrase to find out what others think. We could have dinner at 6, and then go to a movie. How does that sound? For example, let's hire a band to play music, and Brent can photograph the event. How does that sound?
14.
That sounds great. If you like an idea, you can respond to how does that sound? With this phrase. Great can be replaced with any synonym similar word, such as awesome, perfect, excellent, or fantastic. For example, A. My mom is baking cookies this afternoon. We could go to my house and eat some. How does that sound?
B. That sounds fantastic.
15. Oh, never mind. Let's say someone does not understand an idea you are trying to explain. If you have explained it over and over and want to stop, just say oh, never mind. You can now talk about something else. You can also use never mind to mean it does not matter or just forget it. In these situations, say it with a smile and positive tone, though. When you say this phrase slowly with a falling, low tone, it can mean you are bothered or upset. For example, A. Are you going to the grocery store today?
B. No, I am not.
But why? Do you need something?
A. Oh, never mind.
It is okay, I will go tomorrow.
16.
I am learning English. This simple phrase tells people that English is not your native language. If you are a total beginner, add just started after I just started learning English. For example, my name is Sophie and I am learning English.
17.
I do not understand. Use this phrase when you do not understand what someone means. For example, sorry, I do not understand. The US Electoral College seems very confusing.
18.
Could you repeat that please? If you would like someone to say a word, question or phrase again, use this question. Since to repeat means to say again, you can also ask, could you say that again, please? We can say please either at the end of the question or right after you, like this. For example, could you please repeat that? Could you repeat that, please?
19.
Could you please talk slower? Native speakers can talk very fast. Fast English is hard to understand. This is an easy way to ask someone to speak more slowly. Note, this phrase is not grammatically correct. However, it is used often in everyday, casual speech. The grammatically correct question would be, could you please talk more slowly? That is because slowly is an adverb, so it describes verbs, like talk. Slower is a comparative adjective, which means it should be used to describe nouns, people, places or things, not verbs. For example, my car is slower than yours. For example, A. You can give us a call any weekday from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. at 555-2508, extension 33. B. I am sorry, could you please talk slower?
20.
Thank you. That helps a lot. After someone starts speaking more slowly for you, thank them with this phrase. You can use it in many other situations, too. For example, Ben, could you please make the font bigger? It is hard for me to read the words.
B, sure,
I will change it from size 10 to 16. How is this?
A, thank you.
That helps a lot.
21.
What does group of underscores mean? When you hear or see a new word, use this phrase to ask what it means. For example, A. What does font mean?
B. It is the style of letters, numbers and punctuation marks when you type.
A common font in the USA is Times New Roman.
22.
How do you spell that? English spelling can be tricky, so make sure to learn this question. You could also ask someone, could you spell it for me? For example, A. My name is Roberta Handkerchief.
B. How do you spell that?
23. What do you mean?
When you understand the words one by one, but not what they mean together, use this question. You can ask it whenever you are confused about what someone is telling you. For example, A. The Smiths do have a really nice house, but the grass is always greener on the other side. B. What do you mean? A. I mean that if we had the Smiths' house, we probably would not be happier. We always think other people have better lives than us, but other people have problems, too. 24. Can you help me? If you need help while you are shopping, this is a simple way to ask. For example, can you help me? I cannot find what I want. Excuse me, can you help me? 25. I am looking for. If you cannot find what you want in a store, you can ask a salesperson to help you find it. Just add the name of what you want to buy after the phrase I am looking for. For example, excuse me, I am looking for a winter coat. I am looking for snow boots. Can you help me? 26. Do you have this object in a different color? If you see something you like, but you do not like the color, you can ask if you can get it in a different color. Another way to say this is, does this come in a different color? You can also add the name of the object after this. I do not like this shade of red. Do you have this in a different color? Does this bowl come in a different color? This will not match my kitchen. 27. I do not know my size. Sizes for clothing and other things differs from country to country, so you might have to look up the correct size for the country where you are shopping. For example, if you cannot figure out your correct size, it is perfectly fine to ask for help from the sales staff. I do not know my size. Can you help me? I want to buy a shirt, but I do not know my size. 28. I need this in a size, group of underscores. This is a simple way to ask for a piece of clothing or household item in the size you need, if you already happen to know the right size. For example, I need this in a size 10, please. This is too large. I need this in a size 5. 29. Where can I find item? Since every supermarket is set up, arranged a little differently, we all can have difficulty finding certain items. You can ask someone at this store to help you find what you need with this simple phrase, where can I find? Just add the name of what you want after find. The store clerk might answer you with a phrase like, it is on aisle 8, or, it is in the produce section, near the lettuce. For example, customer, where can I find black olives? Sales clerk, they are on aisle 10, near the pickles. Customer, where can I find a bag of almonds? Sales clerk, they are in the baking section, on aisle 7. 30. How much does this slash that cost? If you are holding something you want to buy, or it is right near you, you can say how much does this cost? To find out, learn the price. You can also put the name of the object you want to after this. For example, I need to buy a toaster. How much does this cost? How much does this shirt cost? If you can see what you want to buy, but it is not right near you, you can point to it and say, how much does that cost? Or how much is that item? How much is that lamp over there? 31. I do not need a bag. Let's say you have bought something small. You can easily carry it. You might tell the sales clerk or cashier that you do not need a shopping bag. You might also say this if you have a shopping bag with you and do not need to get one from the store. For example, no, thank you. I do not need a bag. I can just carry it. I do not need a bag. I brought my own with me. 32. Can someone help me carry this out? If you buy something really large and hard to carry, like a table or a huge order of groceries, you are going to need help. Most stores that sell large and heavy items offer assistance, help, from a member of staff. The staff member can help you carry your purchase, what you have bought, out of the store. They might even help you place it in your vehicle. For example, this is too heavy for me. Can someone help me carry this out? Can someone help me carry this out? I have 18 bags of groceries here. 33.
Can I have this delivered? Sometimes, you need to buy something so large, and so heavy, that there is no way you could bring it home from the store yourself. That is when you will want to ask, can I have this delivered? For example, this refrigerator is perfect. Can I have this delivered? Can I have this delivered next Tuesday? 34. How can I help you? If you work in customer service, you will use this phrase a lot. It is also a common phrase when answering the phone. For example, on the phone, hello, this is Rebecca speaking. How can I help you? 35. I will be with you in a moment. When someone wants to see you, you might not be ready to talk to them. Use this phrase if you need a minute to finish something first. If a client is waiting for help, you can also use this phrase to show that their turn is next. You can replace moment with minute. I will be with you in just a minute. Another common phrase for this situation is I will be right with you. Good morning! I will be with you in a moment. If you are finding these phrases useful, take a look at Creativa, where you will find more useful English phrases for work. Creativa is a new product from the Fluentu team. With useful and surprising tips, Creativa's high-quality videos help you learn skills to communicate well in business English. More than just teaching English words and phrases, Creativa shows you how to use body language and the tone of your voice to better connect with English speakers at work. 36. What time is our meeting? You can use this question structure to ask the time of any event. What time is event? If you want to ask about a meeting on a certain day, add on day. For example, what time is our meeting on Thursday? For example, what time is our meeting on Wednesday? 37. Please call me back at. When you want someone to call you or to call you back to return your call, use this phrase to give your phone number. For example, hi, this is Kathleen from the financial office. I am wondering if you found those missing receipts. Please call me back at 555-5555. Thanks! 38. Oh really? Actually, I thought. When you disagree with someone, actually, I thought, will make you sound kinder and more polite than saying no or you are wrong. This phrase is useful when you have a different idea than someone else. You can use actually, I, with many different verbs, heard, learned, am, can, cannot, etc. For example, so Sam is coming in tonight at 8, right? B, actually, I thought he was not working at all this week. A, oh, okay, I will have to look at the schedule again. 39. When is the deadline? When someone gives you a task or project to complete, you need to know how long you have to finish it. A deadline is a date or time when something must be completely done. You can ask when is the deadline? To find out when you need to be done with your task or project. When is it due? Is another way to ask for this information. A, I need you to write a sales report. B, when is the deadline? A, I need it by next Tuesday. C, please send the customer an estimate. D, when is it due? C, they want it tomorrow morning, before 9:40. I am just about to verb. When you are going to start something very soon, you are just about to do something. For example, I am just about to send those faxes. I am about to go and pick up some coffee. Do you want anything? Thank you for watching my videos. Please subscribe, like and share to channel, Sreyoun in order to get new videos. Thank you.